Police in Seattle catch an armed robber in the act.
It's a terrifying story in the U District where police say a convicted rapist bound a house full of female students at knife point. Dana Rebick is live near this home with the frightening details. Dana?
Well, Seattle police tell us this convicted rapist just got out of prison in January after serving 10 years for rape. And we just printed out these documents from the King County Prosecutor's Office from that 2001 case. And in that incident, he also targeted a University of Washington student, a 19-year-old girl who worked for a local sandwich shop. It sounds like she delivered an order to his apartment. He grabbed her, held her at knife point, and raped her inside of his apartment. Now, in this case from early this morning, police tell us this man also used a knife, broke into a home full of female students from the University of Washington. But luckily, one of them was able to call for help. Police got here in time, and now that man is behind bars.
Crime scene investigators spent most of the morning processing this home, where police say a convicted rapist broke in around 3 in the morning.
He took a rock and covered it with an article of clothing and actually threw it through the window. So it muffled the noise, and he was able to gain entry that way.
Seattle police say 35-year-old Robert Hitt was armed with a knife and one by one started waking up the women who live here.
He rounded up 6 of the 8 women, took them into a room, and he bound them, their hands. And one of the victims, he actually made her disrobe.
2 of the roommates were able to hide and call 911. Police arrived within 4 minutes and arrested Hitt inside the home.
It makes me nervous. I'm from a pretty small town where there's not much crime, and so it's definitely kind of frightening.
Students in the U District are terrified, many who tell us they regularly leave their doors unlocked. Nearby residents are also on edge, including this woman in Laurelhurst. Someone broke into her house 2 days ago in the middle of the night when she and her family were sleeping.
We noticed that our cell phones and purse and wallet and iPad were taken.
The burglars also stole her car. It was one of 3 similar break-ins in North Seattle, all in the same day.
It's disconcerting. You know, we're very grateful that we weren't hurt and they were in and out quickly.
Police aren't saying if these crimes are related to this morning's incident, but are glad they caught this suspect.
We're just really grateful that the 2 victims had the wherewithal to call 911 and that officers responded quickly enough to take him into custody.
According to the Department of Corrections, Robert Hitt was considered a low risk to reoffend when he was released just 2 months ago. And they tell us he was being supervised and most recently met with his community corrections officer just 2 weeks ago. He will be in King County Court tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock p.m. where he will be facing multiple charges, including burglary and attempted rape and kidnapping. Live in the U District, Dana Rebick, Q13, Fox News.